Dear students, today we are taking the second chapter, electrostatic potential and the capacitance. So in this chapter we will learn what is the potential, what is the potential difference, what is the potential energy, electrostatic potential energy, then the capacitance and different combination of the capacitance. So now first of all let us take the electrostatic potential. So suppose if you are taking the plus capital Q charge, that is taken as a source charge, and it has its own electric field around it. So in this electric field, from infinite distance, if you bring any one unit positive charge and if you put that positive charge at the point inside the electric field of the source charge, then what the work done to bring this unit positive charge, let us understand this. So in this figure we are taking the source charge capital Q and we bring the unit positive charge from the infinite point to the A point. Now let us take this unit positive charge, we are putting from A to B position. So we choose two different paths, A to C and C to B, that is the ACB path, and another path A to D and D to B, that is the ADB path. So as shown in this figure, we want to take a unit positive charge plus 1 coulomb from point A to point B. To find work done by electric field during this motion, different path can be thought as we have taken ACB and the ADB. So the work done during the A to B is given by WAB is equal to integration A to B E dot dr. Now let us take for the first part, ACB part. So for that the total work WACB is given by WAC plus WCB. Here WAC work it is E dot dr, but in this case E and dr, small displacement dr, they are perpendicular to each other. That's why E dot dr, that is the E dr cos 90 is become 0. So WAC is become 0. But WCB work, in that work the electric field and the small displacement is not perpendicular, it is in the same direction. So we get the WCB, that is the non-zero. So here WACB is equal to WCB is equal to integration C to B E dot dr is equal to integration C to B KQ upon R square into dr. So by taking the KQ common out of the integration, we get KQ integration R s to minus 2 dr the range C to B. So here we take the RC and RB as a position vector and we get the final equation KQ into 1 upon RC minus 1 upon RB. It is the first equation. In the same way for the ADB path, let us take for the ADB path, what is the total work? The total work done to bring the unit charge from A to D, D to B path is given by WADB is equal to WAD plus WDB is equal to WAD plus 0, because here for the WDB the work is 0. Actually here also electric field and displacement, they are perpendicular to each other. You can see in the diagram that BD is perpendicular to the electric field E. So WADB is given by integration A to D E dot dr is equal to KQ into 1 upon R A minus 1 upon R D. This is the second equation. Now if you see the diagram, then you can get the similarities, that is the RB is equal to RD and RA is equal to RC. So by taking both the equation we get the conclusion that WAB is equal to WACB is equal to WADB is equal to KQ into 1 upon RA minus 1 upon RB. because Ra is equal to Rc and Rb is equal to Rd. So we can put the position vector in the equation and we get WAB is equal to KQ into 1 upon Ra minus 1 upon Rb. So ultimately from these equations we comes to the conclusion that in an electric field the work done by the electric field in moving a unit positive charge from one point to the other point is depend only on the positions, that is the initial position and the final positions of these two points, and it does not depend on the path joining them. So this work done during the motion is not depend on the path chosen, either it is ADB or the ACB. It is depend only on the initial and the final position. So this is the our conclusion. Now let us take the conservative field. So if a unit positive charge you are taking is taken from point A to B, so here we are choosing the different path ACB and the ADB. But now if you choose the path ACBDA or ADBCA path, then if a unit positive charge is taken from point A to B on any path and then is brought back to capital A on any path, a closed loop is formed. So the closed loop is the again ACBDA or the ADBCA. So on this closed loop, the total work done by the electric field, that is the closed integration E dot dr, will be WAB plus WBA is equal to zero. So a field with this property is known as conservative field. So here the electric field is also a conservative field. The conservative field, the meaning of this field is what? The field in which the field does not depend on any path chosen. It depends on the initial and the final position, as well as for the closed loop path, the work done is become zero. So this type of the field is known as the conservative field. In the 11th standard, we have already learned about the gravitational field, which is also conservative field. So we have two conservative field, gravitational field as well as the electric field. So instead of the work done by the electric field, if we want to find the work required to be done with the external force against the electric field, that is for the motion without acceleration, then the negative sign we have to use, because here work is done against the electric field. So in that case we can write WAB dash is equal to minus A to B E dot dr. If you take the magnitude of this WAB dash, then you will get it is same as the magnitude of the WAB. So this is the concept how we can take the unit positive charge from one point to the other point, and this unit positive charge when you bring in any electric field, then what is the work done on that unit positive charge. So based on this concept, now we can understand what is the electric potential, that is the single electric potential, and what is the electric potential difference, and what is the potential energy as well as the electrostatic potential energy for the system of the charges. Now let us take the electrostatic potential. So we are using the concept of the work done to bring the unit positive charge from one point to the other point in the electric field. So to find out the electrostatic potential at the single point, let us take the same सेम कंडीशन वी आर टेकिंग द सोर्स चार्ज कैपिटल क्यू इट हैज इट्स ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कैपिटल ए ई एंड इन दिस एरिया ऑफ द फील्ड वी वॉन्ट टू ब्रिंग अ यूनिक पॉजिटिव चार्ज बट इट इज आउटसाइड द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड फ्रॉम आउटसाइड द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एरिया सो एट द वन पॉइंट वी डिनोट नोन एज द इनफाइनाइट पॉइंट सो एट दैट इनफाइनाइट डिस्टेंस वी ब्रिंग द यूनिक पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड वी ब्रिंग इट फ्रॉम इनफाइनाइट टू द गिवन पॉइंट कैपिटल पी इन साइड द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड सो हियर ऑल्सो वी हैव टू डू द वर्क सो वर्क इज रिक्वायर्ड सो वर्क रिक्वायर्ड टू बी डन अगेंस्ट द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इन ब्रिंगिंग अ यूनिक पॉजिटिव चार्ज फ्रॉम इनफाइनाइट पॉइंट टू द गिवन पॉइंट इन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज कॉल्ड द इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक पोटेंशियल एट दैट सिंगल पॉइंट कैपिटल पी सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक पोटेंशियल इन जनरल इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक पोटेंशियल इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ द वर्क डन इट इज वन टाइप ऑफ द वर्क बट हियर वी आर टेकिंग द यूनिट पॉजिटिव चार्ज हुज वैल्यू इज प्लस वन कूलम सो दैट्स व्हाई द पोटेंशियल एट द पी पॉइंट इज गिवन बाय Vp is equal to integration p to infinite e dot dr. Here, why we are taking the integration? Because we have a range, the infinite point to the p point. So this is the range. So to indicate the range, we are taking the integration. For the small changes or small displacement or small changes. Generally, we are taking the differentiation, but when there is a large range given for the given quantity, then we are using the integration. So here, the potential at the P point is given by infinite to the P point E dot dr. But here, we are taking the electric field and the work done is against the electric field so Vp is given by p to infinite e dot dr is equal to minus infinite to the p e dot dr here we are bringing the negative sign from the integration so while taking the integration sign outside of the integration the positions are interchanged upper position and lower position they are interchanged in the integration so p to infinite e dot dr is written as minus infinite to the p e dot dr this is the single potential at the p point in the same way if we bring the same unit positive charge from infinite to the s point then we get the single potential at the s point is vs is equal to s to infinite e dot dr is equal to minus infinite to s e dot dr. So these are the two equations. Now these two equations indicate the single potential at the p point. In the physics, the single potential means single work has no importance. Single potential has no importance. But now if we take the difference between these two potential, then it is known as the potential difference. So let us take the potential difference between the P and S point. So Vp minus Vs is written as P to infinite E dot dr minus S to infinite E dot dr. Instead of S to infinite E dot dr, we can also write minus infinite to S E dot dr. So we get the P to infinite E dot dr minus infinite to S P dot dr. So ultimately we get the range P to S E dot dr. Integration P to S E dot dr. But here this difference is known as the potential difference is also one type of the work done against electric field. So to indicate against electric field we take the negative sign outside the integration. So Vp minus Vs is written as minus integration S to P E dot dr. Here the meaning of against electric field means against the force by the electric field, and the meaning of infinite distance or the infinite point is it is not the very large distance, but it is the point outside the electric field. So the point or the distance outside the electric field, whatever the distance, is considered as infinite distance, or that point is indicated as a infinite point. So dear students, here we have learned the single potential and the potential difference. Both are work done to bring the unit positive charge from one point to the other point in the electric field and against the electric field. So here main point is we have chosen the plus 1 coulomb charge, that is the unit positive charge. Now in the electrostatic potential energy, we are using the q coulomb charge instead of the 1 coulomb charge. So the definition is somewhat changed. Instead of the unit positive charge, we use the q coulomb charge. Then we get the definition of the electrostatic potential energy. So what is the definition of the electrostatic potential energy? Work required to be done against the electric field in bringing a q coulomb charge from infinite distance to the given point in the electric field is called the electrostatic potential energy at that point. So we can write Vp into q is equal to Up. Capital U is the symbol of the electrostatic potential energy. So Up is equal to q into Vp is equal to integration p to infinite q e dot dr is equal to minus infinite to p q e dot dr. In the same way, we can also write the single potential energy at the S point. Us is equal to q into Vs is equal to minus infinite to S q e dot dr. Here also in physics, the single potential energy is not having importance, but if we take the difference between two points for the potential energy, then the difference in the potential energy is having the importance. So the potential energy difference is given by Up minus Us is equal to integration p to infinite qe dot dr minus integration s to infinite qe dot dr. Ultimately, it is written as integration p to s qe dot dr. But here also, the potential energy is also one type of the work done against the electric field. So it is written with the negative sign. So it is written as the minus integration s to p qe dot dr. So this is the potential energy difference. It is having the importance. In the next session, we will learn what is the example based on potential difference and the potential energy difference.